Hello friends, welcome to 45 Solution. Now today in this video we try to understand what is NDA and what is content. So before to jump to NDA, we should understand what are the case or what are the scenario in which a contract is signed along with the NDA. So we try to understand that, understand the scenario first. Now we take a scenario. In this we have a company called X company, and also we have a company called Y company. Now this X company is having a lot of patent, or you can say the license holder of technology, advanced technology. Okay, and this Y company, it deals with service industry, or you can say or manufacturing industry. So what happened? This X company came up with the product in which he can deliver some technology assistance to this Y company, and in return you can say that this Y company, or in consideration, can pay him a royalty for his technical service assistance. So along with the contract, they decided or they will sign a NDA in this case. Now we'll see what this NDA. Now all we know that X provide some confidential documents like his technology. Now his technology is he's a licensor holder of that technology. So that technology is a, what are documents or details he share with Y, it's a confidential for him, because he invested a lot of money in that and time also to develop that technology. So in this case you can see this X become the disclosing party. Okay, and Y become the receiving party, because he received the technical documents from disclosing party, and X shared the confidential document for some purpose, or said purpose you can say that. We'll see what are the purpose, and Y will use this document only for that purpose only. So this all scenario will capture in NDA. They'll agree in a NDA in this, and that's why the NDA will come up. Now we'll see which are the broadly point are considered in a NDA. So normally NDA consists of 16 clause or 16 point, whatever you say, and along over here we have a sample copy. It just give you, it's a sample copy how NDA is actually look like. It's the first page of NDA sample copy. Normally NDA have 3 to 4 pages, and sometimes annexures, that depend how you define a purpose. Now we'll see one by one which are the points we have. We'll discuss point one by one. The first point is the introductory paragraph. Now what it includes actually. Now normally introductory paragraph includes the name, address and business line of the parties. Now here in this case there was X company and Y company, so both X and Y will different para 1 or para 2 will define what they are and what the line of business and where and their registered office. Along with that, in this we also define the purpose. Now purpose is for what this technology has been taken from, or disclosing party share with the receiving party. Now we'll understand with an example. Now suppose like receiving party, just take it back. Now this receiving party, as we know that he's in service industry, suppose he's in service industry, and what services do he maintain? The client database. He maintain the client database for the third party. Now to maintain the database, he required a software or technology, and from where he get the software and technology? From disclosing party. Okay, now disclosing party is a licensor holder for this database software. Okay, now for, so we have to understand what the purpose of this NDA is. So is this database, because the database is what he wants to maintain, and to maintain this database he requires this technology. So what the receiving party can do? Now receiving party can only use this technology for this database. And that's why, in short, we say it's a purpose. It's the purpose of this NDA. Okay. So we were here and we says that they define their names and then they define the purpose. Along with that, they define the parties also. Now, which are the party? Suppose as an individual, they are party, and if they both talk together in any clause, they say they talk as a parties. They even define the third party. So, and all, if any other definitions are required, which is required for this NDA, they'll define wherein definitions. There's also one point to note that normally this NDA is a one-way agreement in which disclosing party gives the documents or trade secret to receiving party. Okay. Now we move to next clause, which says is definition of confidential information. As we know that we have disclosing party and receiving party. Okay. Now disclosing party have given some confidential documents to this receiving party. Now what this confidential document will be or consist of? Like it might be a drawings, it might be a calculations, it might be a source code, it might be a like a specification. So all these things are will be defined under this confidential information. This means these are the information which this disclosing party gives to receiving party, and that will be treated as confidential information. Okay. Now see, and now we heard there's a third clause which deals with exclusion and for the confidential information. Now what in this clause will includes it will include, it says, what if these details readily available in the open source? Okay, there might be case like some of the drawings will be openly available, or some of the specification or source code will openly available in the net, or openly available. Okay, and then this one, and the second, where suppose what happen as a receiving party itself able to, or they possesses particular document or particular drawing which they themselves develop before the signing of this NDA. So this all particular points will be captured in this exclusion of the confidential information. Okay. And then fourth para or fourth clause, obligation of the receiving party. Now major obligation is this, that whatever information or confidential document, this confidential document what he received from the disclosing party, the receiving party should not disclose with the third party unless he get the written consent letter, or he should sign a similar disclosure or NDA with that third party. That depend upon type of which NDA you're signing. So depend case to case. And then there will be another clause, there's a time period. Now in time period there are three important points. Is the effective date, and from which date this NDA will be effective, and then validity, till when this NDA or secrecy will be maintained, or secrecy maintained by the receiving party. Normally in practice this vary from 5 to 25 years, depend upon what type of secrecy trade you are doing. Okay. Now we move to next, is a relationship. Now what happened, there is a receiving party and disclosing party. We should understand these both are different individuals or a different company. So they both came together for this purpose. And so what happened, this relationship says the relationship is only limited to this NDA only. Means they doesn't have any much relationship beyond this NDA. So this is what defined in this relationship, or limitation to their relationship. The next clause is severability. Now in this we can understand with this example. In 2016 we know that GST came is from 1st July, GST applicable all across India. So what happened? Sir, all VAT, your sales tax, everything got become null and void, and GST become the effective. Suppose that that's some GST clause, suppose that VAT or was included in any of the contract. So because of that particular act or clause become invalid in your country, that doesn't mean that whole contract or NDA will be become null and void. So what this severability says that the only the particular portion will be become invalid, and remaining other clause become will or remain valid. This is what in this we protect ourselves. Okay. Then integration. Now what happened before signing a NDA, both this party, disclosing party and receiving party, they might be did lot of communication with each other, like verbal communication, the meetings, then email correspondence, and they conclude something, and based upon their conclusion only this form this NDA and this agreement. So what this is, whatever they conclude or they become finalized, everything has been concluded with this NDA. So now after the signing of NDA, they can't give the reference of their previous, or before signing of the NDA, they can't give the reference of those correspondence. This is what this, that's what we capture in this integration. Then waiver. Now what waiver clause protects you is this, or protect both the parties, or especially a receiving party, if suppose by law or by legal administration they instructed to disclose some of the confidential information which is essential for their proceeding or for their inspection. So in this case, what the receiving party do, they'll make sure they, the moment they get this what their declaration, or you can say the inquiry, they straight away inform the disclosing party so that they can protect themselves. And in any way, they'll make sure that, or receiving party make sure that they disclose the minimum information of this confidential document. Now why they keep this clause waiver? Because if we don't have this clause and we have an inquiry, or by law we have to disclose this confidential document, then it becomes breach of this contract or breach of this NDA. So to protect that one, this waiver we have. Then we also have injunctive relief. Now what this injunctive relief is do, suppose any of suppose the relief receiving party share some documents with other party, and they were try to establish that this document they are sharing, which was also part of NDA, it's a common document, means it's readily available for all. It's not fall in confidential document. So there's a dispute in that, dispute with your disclosing party. So in this case, what the disclosing party will do, they take the help of court and they get this injunctive relief. So that by this, until this matter is not settled in the court, or matter is not resolved, that documents which receiving party says which is open is available in the available, they can't disclose with this, they have to stop disclosing with third party. Okay. Now next we'll say indemnify. Now what this indemnify includes, it says that both the parties will indemnify what are the consequences happened due to this NDA. So this is a very protective clause, and mostly it's in the purview of legal they kept. Now next is attorney fees and expenses. Now what if later onwards you went to litigation or arbitration, then who will bear the charges for this litigation and arbitration? That's what defined in under this clause. And then also we have a clause jurisdiction and governing law. That is very critical one, that this NDA will be where this, what will the governing law of this NDA, and what will the arbitration law, which arbitration law will be applicable, and where will the place and seat of this arbitration, everything will be captured under this jurisdiction and governing law. Then there's another clause which says succession and assign. Now all we know that this NDA was signed between disclosing party and receiving party. So disclosing party have to give receiving party make sure they keep this document confidential. They're not supposed to share with any third party until unless they get the written confirmation from disclosing party. What if the party is got acquired with other party? So in this case, this party bind not to disclose with their other company with whom it they acquired. So they protect under this clause. And the last, normally signatures. It's quite very well aware to all that only authorized person should sign this document. Now in this case, what they do, they make sure they sign two copies so that both copies will become original and kept with each party. So broadly, this is outline how NDA is signed, and these are the clauses we have in NDA. And that's it for this video. Take care. Rab Rakha.